Going to call Dr. Kumagai, the county coroner, Your Honor.
There are three depression fractures, like from a heavy, blunt instrument, maybe a hammer. Here, here, and here. This and this over here are sharp depenetrations of the skull and of the brain, like with a hatchet or maybe a meat cleaver.
Now, Doctor, I call to your attention the results of the forensic chemist's analysis, States Exhibit 63.
Yes. Okay.
I think we might just nail this sucker.
And that report states that the specimen of semen taken from Miss Palemis's body has been identified as being of Mr. Savage's blood type. Am I correct?
You are correct.
It also indicates the presence of chemicals consistent with the use of a birth control device, a diaphragm.
It does.
Now, your opinion is that this was a staged rape?
That is my opinion.
And that the way it was done suggests the knowledge of investigative techniques.
Yes, that's what I told Mr. Moto.
And all of these deductions depend on the presence of spermicidal jelly in the specimen you sent to the forensic chemist, do they not?
Yes, sir.
How many autopsies do you perform in a week, Dr. Kumaga?
Oh, one, two, ten. It all depends.
Would it surprise you to know that you performed 18 autopsies in the 2 weeks surrounding Caroline Palemis's death?
No, sir. Sounds about right.
And given that number, isn't it fair to say that the specifics of any one examination may slip your mind?
I take notes while I do the autopsies.
Notes, yes. Well, these notes led you to tell Detective Lipranzer that the murderer was sterile. Looking back, you must have thought you were a fool to have escaped something so obvious as the use of a contraceptive spermicide.
All the sperm were dead. I didn't have the forensic chemist report about the spermicidal jelly. In absence of any other explanation, I thought the guy was sterile.
Do you recognize your notes of your autopsy of Miss Palemis, Dr. Kumaga?
Yes, sir. My signature.
Unless there is any objection, would you please read the short passage marked by the paper clips? Page 2, counsel. Read it out loud, please.
The fallopian tubes are ligated and separated. Ephemerated ends appear. Not right.
Your own autopsy notes? You dictate them as you perform the procedure, do you not?
Not right.
I show you the records of Dr. Lubin, a gynecologist, and of the hospital where he performed this procedure on Miss Palemis 6.5 years ago. Would you explain to the jury what a tubal ligation is? Would you explain in layman's language what a tubal ligation is?
She had her tubes tied.
Is it possible for a woman with this procedure to conceive a child?
No way.
Can you think of any reason for a woman who had her tubes tied to use a spermicide?
No reason, no medical reason. I think of nothing.
Does it not follow, given these facts, that the specimen you sent to the chemist was not taken from the body of Caroline Palemis?
I can't account for it.
Oh. So you don't know what happened